When I arrived here in 2018 for the first time, I saw all the players that were playing here. There was a small club. It was like in a small town, and I saw a lot of potential. But I always knew that when I had the chance to run a club, I always knew that I wanted everyone to learn the backstage also, not only get on the horse and play.
Salió la posibilidad de venir con Pablito acá a Luxemburgo, así que bueno, vinimos, un club bastante lindo, muy buenas personas, un ambiente muy entretenido y nada, contentos y con ganas de estar todo el año.
I wanted everyone to learn how to prepare a horse, how to take care of the horse, how to wash a horse, how to exercise a horse. So in the future they will have more tools to understand polo and to play better, of course, because when you know the horses, when you know the work of the grooms, when you know how does it work, you understand polo. For me, people doesn't have to learn how to play polo, people they need to understand how polo works.
Buenísimo que siendo jugadores aprendan también cómo se cuida un caballo, cuál es la rutina, los horarios, entender cómo vive el caballo es fundamental para que se puedan desarrollar como buenos jugadores.
In our club we have the big advantage that all the kids that are playing with us and all the players that are playing with us and all the parents that are playing, they are involved in the organization of the club and the tournament. They all come to help with the horses, they all come to help with the preparation of the tournament, and it's like a family club.
Notamos que en el club es un ambiente muy familiar donde todos aportan algo, así como los chicos ayudando y cuidando sus propios caballos y entrenando ellos. A su vez, sus padres y la familia de ellos siempre están colaborando con algo.
Yo noto, sí, eso, que es muy familiar, y acá en Luxemburgo se han dado las condiciones para que el polo verdaderamente se desarrolle.
The kids, they help inside the stables because I think it's the way I learn about polo. Back when I was kid in Saladillo, and here I try to change that mentality and to make it open for everyone. So that was my challenge last year, and this year when I came here from Argentina, I started to discover that all the seeds that we planted last year, they started to grow this year, and so we have a lot of lessons that we give during the week. For me, it's special because it reminds me a lot to Argentina and to the club where I will learn to play, that everyone was helping or everyone was trying to do something for the club. I never like to use the word clients for the people that we have in the club. For me, they are friends who are learning how to play polo. They are improving their polo. And you know, when you start to treat them like clients, I feel like I will lose this feeling of friendship. Because when you teach a sport, especially polo, you have to wake up an emotion of the people, on the people that you teach. You have to, when someone is learning a sport or is learning something and this person is sad, he doesn't learn. When this person is happy, I'm sure they will learn more. The short-term plan for Polo Club Luxembourg is to keep going with the lessons, to increase the number of members, to increase the number of players that they can play the real Chakras. In the long term, we're planning to grow the club as much as possible, to get more horses, to get more horses for the polo school, to, of course, to keep improving the field. As long as we can improve everything, we will improve, and I'm sure that all the kids, they will become good players, and they will be the future of the polo in the country.